drive on the left shoulder to get west of Gator Country. So there is some backup in that area. It took us a little bit longer, going about 8 miles an hour to get through there. But then it was free and clear all the way to about Jenkins Road, which is the Stuckey's gas station exit. And then it goes down to one lane for just a short period of time, but no big traffic issues there. Now, here at Hampshire Road, I spoke with a woman this afternoon whose car flooded out at this exit, and she was here when I-10 started flowing again.
It was really eerie, though, because I was walking on that pavement, and it was deserted. Once I-10 opened, it was like a floodgate.
Now, it's great for us Southeast Texans to have I-10 back open between Beaumont and Winnie. But remember, if you're headed to Houston, there is still that closure on I-10 in Channelview where the barge damaged some of the highway bridge. So that closure remains on I-10 just way farther west from us. Reporting live in Hampshire, Leah Durain, 12 News.
And yet there are other roadways, and thank you, Leah Durain, for that live report. And yet there are other roadways all around Southeast Texas that are of a major concern as well.
Absolutely. Leah just hit on the I-10, still closed in the Baytown, Houston area at the San Jacinto River Bridge. Let's hit some of the others. FM 1009 in Jefferson County off of Highway 90, it's closed. FM 1135 in Orange County is closed just south of the Interstate to Orangefield Road. Also, FM 1442 in Orange County closed from just south of the interstate to Orangefield Road.
State Highway 12 closed between Old Buena Road and North Linscomb Road in Orange County. Highway 73 between Taylor Landing and Winnie closed. Highway 105 between Bevel Oaks and Sour Lake closed. And Highway 124 from Finette to Hampshire closed, along with Highway 326 between 105 and US 90 also closed, although there are a few spots, even many of these roadways, some spots out there where you may be able to kind of make it through. But these are the official reports from TxDOT for us.
We know it's a little tedious to run through that, but that's one of the top questions we're getting from you right now. We want to make sure you have that information.
And we'll have more of the same throughout this broadcast.
Oh, yeah.
News you can use. We want to give you that
it's
much
essential.
At least. And